When out on any wildlife photo expedition, one of the most coveted, maybe natural, desirable shots is to photograph animal behavior. That could be pretty much anything, whether it's a fox trotting down a trail, bears sparring, eagles soaring. Those are behaviors. It's not just an animal sitting still. Those are great shots too, and we'll talk about those as well. However, wildlife behavior is really the core of wildlife photography. So how do we do that? How do we capture awesome wildlife behavior? Hey, Court here at Nat Hab's Bear Camp. We're in the southern edge of Lake Clark National Park, deep in the Alaska wilderness. We're on the revered platform here at Bear Camp, looking out at the incredible meadow behind us. A quick disclaimer in all this is that you're gonna see a lot of us walking around and a lot of bear camp shots. Don't ever do this by yourself. Don't ever do it without proper bear knowledge, and always listen to your guide. So quick tip on that. Okay, photographing wildlife behavior is one of the most classic, iconic types of wildlife photography. You're documenting action. It's just stupendous when everything goes right in your favor. So let's talk about how to stack the deck in your favor. We're watching these couple of bears over here. We've been here for an hour or two, just taking in all the different bears and all the landscapes. But these two right here are about to have an interaction. So how do we capture that interaction? Well, of course, you see me, I'm shooting well in advance. I'm not waiting for that exact moment because you never know. One slight turn of the head, one little sniff in the air can be a really, really great shot when you get two bears together. So of course, I'm starting pretty wide. So I'm getting both bears in one frame. And as they get closer and closer here, I'm zooming in. And I'm kind of filling the frame with these two guys because we want to capture that dramatic action. It might be a little snarl of the lip. It might be something we're not even expecting. So you want to choose the appropriate shutter speed to freeze that motion. Usually that's going to be somewhere between 1 over 500 and 1 over 1,000. However, for really fast moving wildlife, like a bear splashing in the river here that we saw just a little bit ago, it could be that you need to shoot 1 over 1250, 1 over 1500, 1 over 2000. These are all shutter speeds measured in 1/2000th of a second, so it's very, very fast. You know, pretty good sunlight today. I am at 1 over 700 right now. I think that's gonna do the trick, but I'm monitoring that. And if these guys do stay doing what they're doing, I'm gonna review my shots and zoom in and see if there's any motion blur. Sometimes intentional motion blur can be really, really great, but if it's just a little bit and it's not deliberate, and it's not set up with intention, basically, it can ruin the shot. So that's the really, really key thing for wildlife behavior photography. The bears just took off, the one chased the other way. I'm gonna dial my shutter speed up with my dial. I'm now 1 over 1500 and I'm snapping away. I'm actually gonna zoom out because it's hard to track this guy, so I wanna leave some space in the scene. I do not have it cropped in tight because I'm probably gonna crop it on the computer. I don't wanna try to set up the perfect rule of thirds as this guy's sprinting down the meadow as he keeps on going. There's a lot of great wildlife portraiture of solo bears, but as soon as you start seeing two coming together, that's when the action really starts. Fast shutter speed, don't worry about composition so much. Zoom out a little bit so you can leave yourself space to move around in the frame, but really it's about capturing that moment and freezing the action in camera. So we're talking about wildlife and landscape shots. It's actually one of my personal favorite shots. It's widely underutilized because it's so coveted and so instinctual to just zoom in on the big animal, zoom in the big wildlife, fill the frame. We're gonna get to that in a little bit, but what we really wanna do is create a landscape shot with wildlife in it. So how do we do that? So the first thing I'm looking at is, of course, trying to find the wildlife, trying to find a beautiful landscape in the background. Fortunately here in Lake Clark National Park, it's in like all directions, so we're good to go there. But I'm seeing a bear just in front of a magnificent mountain range in the distance here, and that's my shot. That's what I'm gonna go for. So how do we set it up? What are the main steps to get us to the final result? Well, we got composition. The first thing I always start with is rule of thirds. So I'm putting that bear just in the bottom left-hand corner at that intersecting point of rule of thirds. I'm getting that mountain range in the top two-thirds, a little bit of sky above it. With this beautiful little river here, I'm gonna use some leading lines, kind of sweeping in and directing the eye towards the mountain range in the background. And I'm really just gonna take a landscape shot, but make sure that that bear is somewhat of a focal point. So the other big part of it, once we have the composition, is the camera settings. It's a pretty classic landscape setup. We're using a 24 to 105 millimeter here on a full frame camera. and I'm going to be shooting in a typical landscape aperture. That means like f8, f11, something in that range. I'm not going to try to get the subject in focus with the background blurred like I would do for wildlife portraiture. It's a landscape shot through and through. And because I'm relatively distant from the bear is part of that landscape. It is almost part of that mountain range. I don't have to worry about that depth of field. I'm just shooting at f8 right now. I'm going to be looking for something 1 over 250 shutter speed and above. And then a low ISO. We want a good high quality shot, so that lowest as possible. Today I could probably get ISO 200. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to keep on taking at different zoom levels. This is a zoom, medium zoom, wide angle, 24 to 105, so taking it super wide and then just taking 3 or 4 shots notching in steadily is really, really great. You can always crop in on the computer, but making sure you have the raw data is a huge part of big landscape shots because it's gonna look considerably different in the screen versus on your computer. So getting the big picture, if you need to, cropping in after the fact is definitely the way to go because it really through and through is a landscape shot that features wildlife prominently. And it might be one of your favorite photos of the trip. All right, next up, we're setting ourselves up for some great wildlife portraiture. We've moved down from the top of the platform down to a little bit more of eye level with the bears, and that's a key thing when photographing for portraiture settings. What is portraiture? Well, it's basically kind of an edge-to-edge filling the frame with the subject. We know portraiture is a common term for people. You probably got school photos done at some point, and it's a headshot, or it's just part of the body, but it's really filling the frame. For wildlife portraiture here, we've got a bear that's approaching somewhat close. We want to be very quiet, I'm sort of waving my hands a little bit too much. We want to be really, really inviting for the bear to keep it around. Mix that with a good 100 to 400 telephoto zoom lens, and we're going to be able to zoom into that bear and fill the frame. That's the key thing. A little bit of nice sunlight coming out. I can probably go up to f11 to really ensure that that bear, every single hair on its nose is in tack sharp focus. Let's go to f11 and see how that turns out. So of course, once we're at a big F number or a small aperture, we gotta think about the other considerations. How does that deal with ISO and how does my shutter speed affected? Really, shutter speed, you just need to move fast enough or shoot fast enough to minimize hand movement and then any sort of bear movement. But in this case, this bear's just kinda sitting here looking around. So I'm actually at 1 over 320, which is pretty slow for wildlife, but it's allowing me to be at ISO 200. Nat Hab's bear camp is extraordinary. I've now just spent several days out here, and of course the bears behind me and all over. I'm counting like 13, 15 bears just in one view. It's in the heart of wilderness. It's in the heart of wild Alaska. It's in the heart of bear country, the highest concentration of brown bears on planet Earth. And we have this really cool luxury camp set up in this wilderness in a super sustainable way, in a way that's been bringing visitors here for some time to learn a deeper way to appreciate nature, to get out there further. And I think it really taps into Nat Hab's sense of luxury of, it's not the clawfoot bathtubs, it's not the chandeliers, it's being with your creature comforts further out there than anyone else can possibly do for you. And that's Nat Hab's bear camp.